My pranams to all Atma Jyotis, Divine Light of the Self. Today we are going to continue with the Bhrguvalli, the third chapter, first shloka of Taittiriya Upanishad. Bhrgurvai
Bhrgurvai
Varunihi
Varunihi
Varunam
Varunam
Pitaram
Pitaram
Upahasara
Upahasara
Adihi Bhago
Adihi Bhago
Brahmeti
Brahmeti
Tasma
Tasma
Etat
Etat
Provacha
Provacha
Annam
Annam
Pranam
Pranam
Chakshuh
Chakshuh
Shrotram
Shrotram
Mano
Mano
Vachamiti
Vachamiti
Tagum Hovacha
Tagum Hovacha
Yetova
Yetova
Imani
Imani
Bhutani
Bhutani
Jayante
Jayante
Yena Jatani
Yena Jatani
Jivanti
Jivanti
Yat
Yat
Prayanti
Prayanti
Abhisamvishanti
Abhisamvishanti
Tadvidtad
Tad
Vijidnasasva
Vijidnasasva
Tad Brahmeti
Tad Brahmeti
Satapotapyata
Satapotapyata
Satapastatva
Satapastatva
Iti Prathamo
Iti Prathamo
Anuvakaha
Anuvakaha
The Bhrguvalli is a third chapter of Taittiriya Upanishad. Bhrguvalli is a recording of realization of Bhrgu Maharshi. How Bhrgu Maharshi realized Brahman. Bhrgu Maharshi's father was Varuna. Varuna also is a realized person. Varuna was a Brahmadnani. Bhrgu Maharshi goes and asks his father, seeks the teaching of Brahman, teaching of self-realization. See, very strange thing. The father is a realized person. Father has many, many students who come to learn about Brahman. But father doesn't teach the son without asking. Okay, this is important aspect of spirituality. Spirituality is taught to people who seek. If there's no seeking, there's no teaching. Even if it's father and son, father, just because it's son, you will not teach.
Okay.
Totally agree. So what happens is many of our people, they get a little bit exposure to spirituality. So then they start teaching their friends. I'll teach you about Brahman, I'll teach you about self-realization. It doesn't work that way. Okay, so these people understand a little bit of spirituality through some books and or some teachings. Then they are enthusiastic, nothing wrong in their enthusiasm. They'll call other people, okay, so no, see, very important to get self-realization, I'll teach you about self-realization. That fellow will say, oh. So it doesn't work, okay, unless you seek, you will not get it. Seeking is very important. It is like giving food to somebody who is not hungry. He will not eat the food. He will just throw it out. Okay? Self-realization is for people who have a seeking, who has hunger for that. If there is no hunger, there is no seeking, there is no teaching. So self-realization is so important, Brahmadnan is so important, why it is not taught to everybody? Because people don't seek it. What is the point? What people, there is religion is taught to people, okay? There's so much of religion which is there all around. Don't mix up religion with spirituality. Like people say, don't mix religion with politics. I say, don't mix religion with spirituality. Religion is for masses, okay? It's about following something. You believe in this God, go to this temple, go to this yatra, do something. It's about doing something. Spirituality is not about doing something, it is seeking something. is seeking which is within. So now start using the same. There's a lot of religious propaganda goes on. You get converted, like political propaganda. You convert this religion, that do this, that believe in that. Okay, believe in this, like that it goes on. So many people have a confusion about religion and spirituality. Spirituality and religion, they are not same. Okay, religion is about God. Spirituality is realizing God. Okay, if you think that people who are seeking God, they want to realize God, you are mistaken. Most of the people who seek God are seeking God or worshipping God, mostly for some of solving their problems. Nobody really wants to seek God. Okay, nobody wants to really realize God. Even the deeper urge is that, most of the time it is only superficial. Okay, spirituality is for people who want to realize God, not for any other benefit, but to simply realize the God within. So Bhrigu is seeing his father teaching many students. People are coming and they're learning something and going. So now this Bhrigu approaches his father, please tell me about Brahman, the supreme reality. So will the teacher tell all of a sudden only one shot? He will not tell.
You say go ask your mom.
Okay, this is the technique of the teaching. He will not tell everything once all of a sudden. He will give a curiosity. Then you go and do something.
Humanity is going for a long time.
He'll give a little bit, okay? If you ask for sweet, just give a sample. Then okay. Like that. So Bhrigu Maharshi says, Annam Pranam Chakshu Shrotram Mano Vachamiti. Annam is food. Annam is the matter. Pranam is the life force, the vital energy. Shrotram is hearing. Okay. Manas is mind. Vacham is speech. So these things, Anna, Prana, Manas, walk. These are what living beings are made up of. These five things, what living beings are of. All living beings are made up of Anna, the food, Prana, energy, walk, Shrotram, hearing, Manas, mind, and walk. Go and seek something from which all these living beings are born. All these living beings are growing up. And all these living beings go and go back. Birth, sustenance, and death. From which all these living beings are born, in which all these living beings grow, and into which all the living beings go back. So seek that itself is Brahman. Know that Brahman. No, that itself is Brahman. So what is the condition for Brahman? What is the condition for reality? A reality has to be all pervading. Something which from living beings are born, something which living beings grow up, and something which you do die. So there they cannot live outside that reality. Okay, it should be all, total. So that reality you seek and know that reality as Brahman. See, this is actually like scientists, no? Scientists say, science, what is the fundamental nature of matter? We'll see. Seek. Okay, fundamental nature means there should be some condition to be met, right? It should be a part of everything. Okay, now let us say something is there in this wall and something is not there in water, it's not fundamental. Something which is common to all, something which exists in all, we have to seek. So what is that which you seek in all, of which exists in all? In the stone, if you go to molecules are there, atoms are there, energy is there, okay, subatomic particles are there. When you go to subatomic particle level, everything has a subatomic particle, same nature. So scientists are seeking what is common to all. So Brahman is what is there in all. So the condition which is applied is something which is born, something grows, something decays and dies, that know that to be Brahman. So Bhrigu goes and does tapasya. Tapasya means thinks over. Okay. So you ask self-realization, how is it possible? So then self-realization requires a tapasya. Tapasya means deeper thought process. So constant deep meditation, thinking about subject with focus, attention. So what is the tapasya means? You can actually say a concentrated study of some subject. Okay. So when a student studies any subject for examination, it's tapasya. Somebody studies, some scientist goes deeper into any subject, it's called tapasya. Somebody who is doing exercise, physical exercise, and focus on his body for building the body, it's called tapasya. So tapasya also can be applied for searching for the truth. Tapasya can be applied for something, many things. You can do tapasya for getting money, and I have heard of tapasya for getting married also, right? People do constantly think and try to find out some way of doing it, right? Tapasya for divorce also. So various things people do tapasya. Okay. So now the question is, tapasya for higher truth is called, higher truth is uplifting. You can do tapasya for anything, right? Tapasya is there for everything, right? Okay. So tapasya is focusing your attention on subject, thinking, analyzing, and coming to a deeper conclusion yourself. So the Brahman also, you have to come, it's not that Brahman will stand in front of you one day. You have to understand, contemplate, think, and come to a conclusion. Okay, so eliminate all not possibilities, then what remains is Brahman. So unless you are able to do that analysis, what you call as, this is called neti neti. So not this, what is not Brahman you have to eliminate. Then you come to a realization of Brahman. Okay, so most of the people think that Brahman realization is a something like a positive aspect. So suddenly someday Brahman will come and stand in front of me. No. Brahman will realize through the process of Viveka and Vairagya. Viveka is to know the distinction between what is Atma and what is Anatma. Separate out Atma and Anatma, self and the non-self. Okay, ability to separate out the self from the non-self, right? Ability to find out satya and nitya and anitya, what is eternal, what is non-eternal. So what is, how do you have to pray Brahma? You have to find out what is eternal, drop what is not eternal. You have to find out what is Atma and drop what is not Atma. So by that process you will attain Brahman. So Bhrigu Maharshi gives him first instruction. Okay, the idea is to create curiosity. Idea is not to give spoon feeding. Idea is to give, set him on the path so that he discovers the Brahman himself. If you think that Guru will give you Brahman on a spoon, okay, it is not possible. Because Brahman is not an object. Brahman is the subject. Guru only can point fingers at that reality. You don't catch the finger, go and catch the reality. Right? I have heard of one story which is happened in ashram. Okay? There's one lady. So Guruvina Gulama Nagadanaka Duraidanda Mukti. That's without becoming a servant of Guru, you can't get Mukti. That is the story. So this lady has understood it very properly. When Guruji comes to the ashram, she holds the feet of the master and says, until you give me Mukti, I won't leave your feet. So the master has very difficult, master has a lot of difficulty in getting liberated from the Mukti from this lady. Okay. So master only, Guru only can point, Guru only can show the direction. It's ultimately you who have to see what is there in the direction and realize. So Varuni, Varuna, father of Bhrigu Maharshi, points out the direction. So now it's for the Bhrigu to go. Bhrigu goes and meditates. This tapasya. Annam.
Annam.
Brahmeti.
Brahmeti.
Vijanath.
Vijanath.
Annadeva.
Annadeva.
Kalu imani.
Kalu imani.
Bhutani.
Bhutani.
Jayante.
Jayante.
Annena.
Annena.
Jatani.
Jatani.
Jivanti.
Jivanti.
Annam.
Annam.
Prayanti.
Prayanti.
Abhisam. Vishantiti Tadvidnaya Punareva Varunam Pitaram Upasasara Adihi Brahmo Bhagavo Brahmeti Tagum Hovacha Tapasa Brahma Vijitnasasva
Tapo
Brahmeti Sa Tapo Tapyata
Sa
Tapastaptva
Iti
Dityo
Anuvakaha.
So Bhrigu, Bhrigu, he does tapasya, he analyzes, then comes to conclusion. What is the conclusion? Annam Brahmeti Upasita. Anna, the food itself is Brahman. What is this food? Food is actually the matter, the five elements, right? The space, the air, the sunlight, the water, and the earth. All living beings are born in matter, they grow in matter and die and go back to matter. Right? So the matter is, from matter, all living beings are born. They take food, right? We actually eat, when we eat food, what food do we eat? We eat apple, rice. All these things are coming because they are byproduct of the nature. And when we die, what happens? The body goes back to the earth if it's buried, or if it's burnt, it'll go to five elements. So Bhrigu comes to a first conclusion. Anna itself is Brahma. Anna means not food. Anna is matter. Matter consists of panchabhutas. Food itself is Brahman. Okay, annam brahmeti upasita. So he comes to a conclusion. Is it right conclusion? Father has told earlier that Brahman, the characteristic of Brahman is something from which everything is born, something into which everything grows, and something which receives after everything dies. So naturally matter itself has all this characteristic. So Bhrigu comes back and tells the father, Anna itself is Brahman. Okay. So then what father says? You stupid fellow, you didn't understand. Did he say that? Okay. Did he scold him? Okay. Did he say that it's wrong? He didn't say that. He says, further do tapasya, you'll find out. He encourages, okay, you have done something. Now you do something little bit more. Do some tapasya, some more meditation. find out. Okay? Tapas itself is Brahman. The tapas means the ability to concentrate, ability to focus and do something itself is Brahman. See, we have most of our people, we think what is spiritual. No, 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 I don't have to do anything. I am spiritual. Hey, Baba, what do you mean by that? Ability to focus and do something is also spiritual act. So, Brahman did tapasya. And out of tapasya, he created this universe. So, the universe is nothing but manifestation of tapas of Brahman. So, tapas is the power of Brahman. Tapas itself is Brahman also. When I say tapas is Brahman, tapas is the ability of the Brahman. Like the ability of the fire is to burn, ability to concentrate, focus and do something is also ability of Brahman. Okay, so Varuna tells Prabhu, you go and do some more tapas. He didn't scold him. He didn't give him the truth also. Okay, he didn't tell the truth also. Right, he encouraged him to do more tapasya and discover the truth. Prano
Brahmeti
Vijanat
Pranadeva
Khalu Imani
Bhutani
Jayante
Pranena
Jatani
Jivanti
Pranam
Prayanti
Abhisamvishantiti Tadvidnaya
Punareva
Varunam
Pitaram
Upasasara
Adihi
Brahmo
Adihi
Bhagavo
Brahmeti
Tagum Hovacha
Tapasa
Brahma
Vijitnasasva
Tapo
Brahmeti
Satapostapyata
Satapastaptva
Iti Tratiyo Anuvakaha. So now Prabhu goes and does further tapasya. So what is important for all living beings? He comes to a conclusion. Prana. Okay, without prana, nobody can live. Right? The prana is one which makes you alive. The prana is one which keeps you, your body alive. The moment prana enters into your body, you become alive. The prana is the one which keeps your body alive. And once prana goes, the living being dies. So, prana has also the characteristic of Brahman. Okay? That's what is the conclusion. The prana has five elements. It's called prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. These are the five elements of prana. The main prana is called mukhya prana. Mukhya prana, when it enters into our body, it takes the five forms. Prana, apana, vyana, udana, samana. Prana is upper part of the body, responsible for heart and lungs and vital organs to function. Apana is the lower part of the body, which goes and it's used for excretion and childbirth, like that activities, lower birth. Samana is in between the two, prana and apana. Samana is responsible for distributing the energy in the body. Prana, apana, samana, udana, vyana. Udana is actually something which takes us, udana is in the upper part of the body, the head portion, which is responsible for our consciousness, various states of consciousness, waking, dreaming, deep sleep, and mukti, enlightenment. Then there is udana, vyana. Vyana is actually radiates from the center of the body, heart of the body, and spreads throughout the body, spreading the energy. Okay. So now these five pranas are there. Without these five pranas, nobody can survive. And if prana is not going to some part of the body will become paralyzed. That part becomes paralyzed. So prana is most important for living. And once somebody dies, the prana goes out of the body and the body is dead. So then Varuna comes, Bhrigu comes back and tells his father, prana itself is Brahman. Right?
Prabhu, but what is this process of contemplation? Like, was he a layman who went to Varuna and told, teach me Brahman?
No.
Like, when he says, do tapasya, what did he exactly do? How did he come to this conclusion that, one by one?
It is...
Hey, suppose I come to you and, I want to...
No, they had an education of all this Ayurveda and all this education they had.
Okay. So he is familiar with all the...
All those. Their schooling was done.
Okay.
That their schooling, they know about prana, apana, vyana, udana. They know about the nature, the interactions.
Okay.
Vedas also they know. So Upanishad only is last part.
Okay.
So they are well educated. It's not a layman in that sense. So you are thinking there is something wrong with me. I can't find out like that. Suddenly you discover prana is where it comes from.
Yeah.
It doesn't come like that. There is an education. There is a what you call as education about life.
Yeah.
As a part of Ayurveda, all these things are they know.
Yeah.
So, what is that? First he realized Anna is Brahman. Second he realized prana is Brahman. Okay. Now why is prana is why prana is not Brahman? Anybody, any of you can tell? Prana gives us the characteristic. No, without prana you can't live. Right? Why prana is not Brahman? The prana has no ability of its own. Body has no ability of its own. The body gets the ability when the consciousness is present, chaitanya. The prana gets ability to move and do functions when the chaitanya is present. Right? Chaitanya is one which gives the life to the prana. If there is no prana, this chaitanya doesn't operate. So prana is just a machine. Prana is just an instrument. Understand? So that's why Sri Madhvacharya says Hari Sarvottama Vayu Jyotama. Vayu is prana. Hari is consciousness, chaitanya. Without chaitanya, the prana also doesn't operate. Prana is not fundamental, primary. Okay. So he goes, Varuna goes and he is very, very happy now. Prabhu is very happy. I found Brahman. Okay, he goes and tells his father, Varuna. Prana itself is Brahman. So Varuna didn't get angry with him. Okay. And this guy, who is that? Prabhu. Didn't go and catch his neck of his father. Why didn't you tell me Brahman? Why are you not telling? Like Guru, many people called Guruji. Why Guruji, why you can't give enlightenment to me? As if enlightenment store is there in my house. So Prabhu is not angry with his father, okay? Varuna, you didn't tell me about Brahman. Varuna is encouraging him to go in the right direction and just find out yourself. Okay, now Prabhu is no doubt he is pleased. He has found the source of life. Prana itself, the life energy, vital energy is the source of life. He is coming back and telling his father, the prana is the source of energy. Okay, source of life. So Prabhu says, Varuna says, go and do tapasya. Do meditation, contemplate. Okay? Through tapasya, understand Brahman. Tapo Brahmeti Vijidnaswa. Brahman itself is tapas. So, Bhrigu does the tapasya.
Those days they were not in the hurry for each other. Lifespan was thousands of years.
Tapas doesn't require thousands of years actually. Tapas can happen in a fraction of a second. If you are understanding, thinking that tapas requires growing a big beard and looking weird, then that's wrong. Not definitely wearing half pants and sitting somewhere on cycle. its ability, it is a sharp intellect which has to be applied. If you think that's a function of time, no.
They used to sit for 10,000 years, 20,000 years.
Did you see that?
No.
Huh?
It's written in books.
Which books?
Bhagirada, he did tapasya for 60,000 years. Amma, Amma
Chitrakatha. See, tapasya is not about that. Tapasya is the ability to focus your attention. Okay, anything requires tapasya. For example, if you want to build a house, it requires a tapasya. First you have to concentrate, then building itself is tapasya. It takes time. Right? Now, with that logic we apply to internally. Outside anything takes time, internally it doesn't take time, it requires a flash. This is Brahman. Okay, outside it takes time, but internally it has to happen a flash. Right, there is one lady, okay, who actually saves a lot of money, okay, years and years of saving, because she wants to buy a golden necklace, or a diamond necklace. She makes a diamond necklace, wears it, feels so happy. Okay, she has done tapasya to buy a save the money for necklace and buy the necklace. Okay, so one day suddenly she is not able to find the necklace in its right place. She is so worried. Okay, they start crying. My necklace is gone. Then people ask her, what happened? Necklace is gone. What is there in your neck? Oh, there's necklace. So the self-realization of Brahmajnana is tapasya, but turning your mind from outside to inwards, what is already there, to recognize it. So tapasya for getting a necklace, it takes time. Tapasya for self-realization doesn't take time. It's recognizing what is there inside. Right?
But understanding it and articulating it in a different volume.
There is Brahman cannot be understood. This is the paradox of Brahman. Okay?
But I don't know which side of the paradox I am on.
Okay. So then we will go Mano Brahmeti
Vijanat
Manasohi Eva
Kalu Imani
Bhutani
Jayante
Manasa
Jatani
Jivanti
Manaha
Prayanti
Abhisamvishantiti
Tadvidnaya
Punareva
Varunam
Pitaram
Upasasara
Adihi Bhagavo
Brahmeti
Tagumbhovacha
Tapasa
Brahma
Vijitnasasva
Tapo Brahmeti
Sa Tapastapyata
Iti Chaturtho
Anuvakah. Now, Bhragu does again meditation, contemplates, and comes to a conclusion, the mind is the Brahman, the Manas is the Brahman. Without mind is the one which uses prana, energy. Without mind using the energy, prana, body doesn't move. So let us say I want to lift my hand. The mind has to think that I want to lift my hand. Then the energy flows to the hand. The prana flows. The prana is directed by the mind. What is the relation between prana and the manasu? Prana and mind, what is the direction? What is the relationship? It's like a blind person and a person without a leg. There are two people, two beggars. One is blind and other has no leg. So the person without no leg cannot walk anywhere. The person who is blind cannot see anything. So they join together. The person who is no leg sits on the shoulder of the blind person and says, go this way, that way. And the blind person takes him. So the prana is like a blind person. Prana has to be directed by the mind. Go this way, that way. Right? Mind itself has no ability to go. Mind itself has the ability to think and direct. So mind and prana work together like that. Okay? So now he comes to a conclusion. Mind itself is Brahman. Because mind is higher than prana. Mind is able to direct prana. Okay? Mind is, when there is a desire to take birth, which is in the mind, the body is born. And throughout the life, we live because of desires and fears in the mind. And when the time has come, when the prana is no longer useful, there is a death. So the mind is the substratum of our living. Our birth is because of mind, life is because of mind, and death is because of the mind. That is the conclusion. He comes to his father and tells that. The father is again not angry. He didn't shout at him. The son is also not angry. Father, you are not giving me enlightenment and liberating me. Okay? And unfortunately, in those days, SMS was not there. They had to talk face to face. So he comes back and tells father.
Both of them have infinite patience. He is not stopping going to the teacher. Teacher is not stopping, you know.
Teaching. Okay, so father says, go and do further tapasya, more focused practice, contemplation and meditation. Then you will come to know a Brahman. Tapasya itself is very important because tapasya itself is Brahman. Vidnanam brahmeti.
Vidnanam brahmeti.
Vijanat.
Vijanat.
Vidnanadeva.
Vidnanadeva.
Kalu imani. Bhutani jayante,
Bhutani jayante,
Vidnanena,
Vidnanena,
Jatani jivanti,
Jatani jivanti,
Vidnanam,
Vidnanam,
Prayanti,
Prayanti,
Abhisambishantiti,
Abhisambishantiti,
Tadvidnaya,
Tadvidnaya,
Punareva,
Punareva,
Varunam,
Varunam,
Pitaram,
Pitaram,
Upasasara,
Upasasara,
Adihi Bhagavo,
Adihi Bhagavo,
Brahmeti,
Brahmeti,
Tagam, Bhovacha,
Bhovacha,
Tapasa,
Tapasa,
Brahma Vijidnasasva,
Brahma Vijidnasasva,
Tapo Brahmeti,
Tapo Brahmeti,
Satapo Tapyata,
Satapo Tapyata,
Satapastaptva,
Satapastaptva,
Iti Panchamo Anuvakaha,
Iti Panchamo Anuvakaha.
Okay, now Bhrigu goes back and understand the mind itself is not the final. Mind directs the prana, prana directs the body. But mind itself is not final. There's something which directs the mind. What is the direct mind? The intellect, buddhi, vidnana. Intellect is the one which is directing the mind. Without, if intellect says the mind, go do this, do that. Mind will do. Intellect will analyze what is required to be done and gives the instruction. It's like intellect is the boss. Right? Boss which will tell mind. So mind, intellect must be with intellect is called vidnana here. Ability to understand, ability to decide. That's called vidnana. Intellect, wisdom, knowledge. Alright, not knowledge, intellect. So intellect is the higher, intellect is higher than the mind. So intellect is actually, intellect is the one which directed the mind to take mind and prana to take the body, take get into the body. Intellect is the one who is leading his life. And intellect is the one, at the time of death, there is no desire to further to live, or there is no will to live, then there is a death. So intellect, through with intellect we are born, in the intellect we live and in intellect we die. Intellect is the fundamental for our life. That is the conclusion. So he goes to Bhrigu Maharshi, Varuna. Bhrigu goes to Varuna. Varuna is still patient. He smiles at him. Okay, do some more meditation. Do some more contemplation. Meditation and contemplation is important because meditation and contemplation itself is Brahman. Right. So tapo tapya. He goes back and meditates. Anando Brahmeti.
Anando Brahmeti.
Vyajana.
Vyajana.
Ananda Deva.
Ananda Deva.
Kalu Imani.
Kalu Imani.
Bhutani Jayante.
Bhutani Jayante.
Anandena.
Anandena.
Jatani Jivanti.
Jatani Jivanti.
Anandam.
Anandam.
Prayanti.
Prayanti.
Abhisamvishantiti.
Abhisamvishantiti.
Saisha. Bhargavi, Varuni Vidya, Parame Vyoman, Pratishthita, Sa Yeya, Evam Veda, Pratishthati, Annavan, Annado Bhavati, Mahan Bhavati, Prajaya, Pashubhir, Brahma Varchasena, Mahan Kirtya, इति षष्ठो अनुवाकः
इति षष्ठो अनुवाकः
So Anando Brahmeti Vyajana. Then what is beyond intellect? What is beyond intellect? That is Ananda, the bliss. So whole of existence is pervaded by bliss, pervaded with bliss. It's born in bliss. The living beings seek bliss. And when they merge, when they die, they attain, they merge with that bliss, Ananda. So the life is, the existence is born out of bliss, lives in bliss and dies into bliss. So this is the conclusion which Varuni has, Bhrigu has. One who realizes this actually is a Parame Vyoman. This is the innermost space. This is the innermost reality, Parama Vyoma, the innermost reality of all living beings. One who realizes this, he will attain that Ananda, bliss. One who realizes this, he will attain the same bliss. Annavan Annado Bhavati. So he becomes, for him, there is no shortage of food. In the sense that he will, whatever is required for his life, livelihood, he will attain. The struggle for survival in life drops. What is required for his life survival, he will attain. Then he will have many, many children. Okay, many children is not here referred to the biological children, but the spiritual children. He will have many, many students who will come and study from him about self-realization, Atmanjnana. Bhrigu was actually initially the biological son of Varuna. But when he becomes, when he seeks Vidya, spiritual knowledge from Varuna, he becomes the spiritual son. Okay. But he, father doesn't make any distinction. Father will also, father when he teaches his son, he will not teach, give him special privileges like many of the politicians and people, bureaucrats do. Their children, they give special privilege. There's no special privilege for his son. He doesn't give some special knowledge for his son. He has to study the subject of spirituality just like anybody else also, by doing some service and contemplation and meditation. Varuna Rishi teaches Bhrigu Maharshi the spiritual subject. So then he will get attain prosperity. How does he attain prosperity? If there are many students and if he becomes famous, so the people will give donation and wealth will come to him. And why the wealth? What is the purpose of wealth? The wealth is for, he will use the wealth for, not for self-gratification, but for teaching more students and building ashram, which will help many more people. Maha Brahma Varchasvi Bhava Bhavati. The tejas, the light of Brahman will shine through him. Varchas means, see, we have different abilities. Somebody says, in the prime minister position, somebody says, do something, everybody will do. Why they will do? Because of the power. Varchas is the ability of a person to be, to have tremendous influence without using the force, without using the power. So in his presence, lot of things will get done. But he doesn't use force, doesn't use power. His inner ability shines through him. And in that presence, many things will happen. Just like a flower, when it blossoms, many bees come searching for that fragrance, searching in search of the fragrance, in search of that sweet in the flower. Many, many students will come to him to learn and study about Brahma Vidya. Annam Nanindyat. Tad vratam pranova annam shariram annadam prane shariram pratishtitam sharire prana pratishtita tadedat annam anne pratishtitam saya etad अन्नम मन्ने प्रतिष्ठितम् वेदम् प्रतितष्टति अन्नवान् अन्नादो भवति महान् भवति प्रजया पशुभिः ब्रह्मवर्चसेन महान् कीर्त्या इति सप्तमो अनुवाकः. So here there is something lower and higher is told. Anna, the food, prana, manas, buddhi. So now the ultimate is ananda. Now I want seeking ananda only. I don't want any lower. Prana is not required, mana is required, body is not required. It doesn't work that way. Right? So you need a physical body for realization. Prana, body is made up of anna, the material nature, matter. That's important. Right? Don't nindya, don't have a wrong opinion about body. So now people, there are many people who are so-called spirituality. No, I'm not the body, I'm not the mind, I'm not the intellect. So body is something to be neglected. Right? What kind of negligence they do? Not doing, taking right food, not doing right exercise, or ignoring the body. So none of this is true. Body is to be taken care of because body is required for realization. Prana enlivens the body. Prana is the one which gives life to the body. Prana and Anna, they exist together. We should not ignore. This actually taking care of the body properly, because body is the temple of God. taking care of the body properly is a vrata. It has to be done. It's a worship. So prana becomes anna. Prana operates through anna. Means prana operates through the body. Without body, prana cannot operate. You don't have a vehicle to operate and interact in the world. Prana and anna, that's prana and the body, are not two different things. They are of the